When we're looking at losing weight, the most important thing you've got to do is train yourself to burn energy from the fat burning energy system. And the only way you can train yourself to do that is through fasting. Dr. Mindy here, and on this video, I have more new science for you and some really encouraging information about how fasting can finally get you that weight loss result that you're looking for. So if you're new to my channel, I just want to say welcome, hit the subscribe button and the notification button. I go live every Thursday to answer your fasting questions. And I'm always bringing you new science, new tips, new tricks to make your fasting lifestyle a lot easier, because I'm on a mission to get 1 million people fasting this year. We are going to overturn chronic disease through the principles of fasting. And those of you that share my videos, as always, appreciate you guys. Okay, new study. So remember, whenever you approach a study, you have to have a theory. And the theory on this study was, well, when people make diet changes, what if they fasted first and then made the diet change? So the actual hypothesis of the study was periods of fasting and refeeding, this is important, may reduce metabolic risk factors elevated by Western diet. Now, let's start here for a second. The Western diet, the standard American diet, is killing people and it is making you insulin resistant. The three pieces of the Western diet that you need to know about that are destroying your health are your bad oils, your high refined sugars and flours, and your toxic ingredients. So go back and watch some of the videos I've done showing you how to undo those three things. Now, what they wondered in this study, which is so fascinating, was before somebody made that diet change, what if we took a 5-day period and we had them fast? And in that fast, what they did is they had them do vegetable juice cleanses. So all they did is vegetable juice and vegetable broth. So they didn't do any solid foods, and the calories were kept to 350 calories, around in that area. So that was the 5-day precursor before they went into the DASH diet. Now, the DASH diet is very much like the Mediterranean diet. So before they made the change, they wanted to know, would we get a better result with the Mediterranean DASH diet? Two groups of people, one did this 5-day fast, one didn't do the 5-day fast. And what they found is absolutely 5 days before the diet change, once they got into the diet change, they got better results than just jumping into the diet change itself. So here were the markers that they saw change. They not only saw the gut microbiome change, but they saw immune markers improve. So CD4 cells, T helper cells, these are parts of the immunity you need to fight viruses. So they saw the immune markers change, they saw the blood pressure go down, and they saw weight loss. The people who did the 5-day precursor with this vegetable broth fast, they found that they dropped more weight in the DASH diet. So this is phenomenal news, because that extra weight, and those of you that are struggling to lose weight, just manipulating your diet alone, are gonna find that when you tack on fasting to any diet change, you're gonna get a quicker result. So what can we learn and how can we implement this for our own life? Now, the first thing I want to say on that is that if you want to know how to become a very efficient fat burner, I am teaching that in my July Fat Burner Reset. So please come join me in that. If you're struggling to lose weight, you don't need to be. It's not a calorie in, calorie out game for weight loss anymore. And this study is showing this. So come join me in my Fat Burner Reset. Just put Fat Burner in the comments and my team will send you a link. So, second thing I want you to know is that when we're looking at losing weight, the most important thing you've got to do is train yourself to burn energy from the fat burning energy system. And the only way you can train yourself to do that is through fasting. When we've been looking at diets and changing our diet to lose weight, All we've been doing is trying to manipulate the sugar burner and your energy system. That doesn't work. We've got to train ourselves to be better fat burners. And you can only do that through fasting and all kinds of fasting. So this one just did vegetable broth fasting and vegetable juice fasting. That was how they approached it. So third thing I want you to realize, and this is one I've talked about here that sometimes doesn't get discussed enough, which is in order to make a lasting change in weight loss, in blood pressure, in immunity, you've got to change your microbiome. So when we're taking antibiotics, women who've been on birth control pills for years, when we're eating foods that are packed with pesticides and glyphosate, when we're eating animals that have been pumped full of chemicals, every single day we are destroying our microbiome. And what this study is showing is the most important thing before you make a diet change is to bring back the health of that microbiome and train the body to start to burn energy from the fat burning system. Then when you step into your diet change, you're going to get a better result. So it doesn't matter if you're vegan, doesn't matter if you're carnivore, doesn't matter if you're on some fancy, other diet. When we approach any diet change by putting fasting in front of it and honoring the microbiome, we will get a better result. And that's what this new study is showing. And as always, you guys, I take these studies, I put them in the comments, so please go down into the comments and look at them and grab that study. You guys can dive into it and see it for yourself, share it with your doctor. This is really vital information. Right now, we are suffering as a world with chronic disease. Here in America alone, we're spending 90% of our healthcare costs are on chronic disease, spent on chronic disease. So we can start to change this by matching a fasting lifestyle to some diet changes, and we will get a better result. Now, one last thing. If you do not want to do a broth fast, try doing some more 17-hour, 24-hour fasts. We know that's where we see the microbiome start to shift. So if you're not looking to do a 5-day precursor of a broth fast, then go ahead and do like a 15-hour or a 17-hour autophagy fast, a 24-hour gut reset fast. But whatever diet change you make, if you want a better result, pair fasting to it. And if you guys like this information on the science behind the changes in the gut and what it does to your health, go check out my video I did on can fasting lower blood pressure, because it showed the same thing. We are getting more and more science coming out saying that fasting changes the microbiome and it gets you a better result with whatever you're trying to accomplish with your health. As always, I hope that helps. And put your fasting miracle in the comments so that people can see what fasting has done for you. This is our way out of chronic disease. Hope it helps.